Hi all, myself Srinivas D, Assistant Professor, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, KG Reddy College of Engineering and Technology. In our today's lecture, we are going to discuss about capacitance parameter. So here, if we observe the property of the capacitance is the property of element which opposes the change in voltage. That is nothing but whenever some change in voltage is applied to a particular element, if it is opposes, then it is having capacitance property. So the next one is the element which is having the capacitive property, the voltage across that element cannot be changed instantaneously. So if any element having the capacitance property, if we observe the voltage across that particular element, it cannot be changed instantaneously, then we can conclude that it is having capacitance property. And the capacitance is indicated by C, and the units of capacitance is farad. That is nothing but capacitance is measured in farads. Now we'll see about what is the voltage and current across that particular capacitor. So to calculate the current and voltage at a particular capacitor, here we have taken one capacitor. It is excited by some voltage source. Because of the voltage source, some amount of current I is flowing in the circuit. So from the charge differential, we know that Q is directly proportional to V. From there, we'll get Q equal to C into V. Now by differentiating the equation 1 with respect to time, we'll get dQ by dt is equals to C into dV by dt. So but already we know that dQ by dt is equals to I. So from there I is equals to C into dV by dt. So this is the value of current which is flowing through the capacitor. Now from the current equation, we can write that dV by dt is equals to I by C. Now I am interested to calculate the voltage across a capacitor. Then I'll take dV is equals to 1 by C I into dt. Now I want to calculate the total voltage. To calculate the total voltage from the above equation, we need to integrate on both sides. Now integrate the above equation, we will get integral dV is equals to V, 1 by C is a constant value, and integral I into dt. So this is the value of voltage across capacitor. So what is the voltage across the capacitor? V is equals to 1 by C integral I dt. Now from this equation, if you observe, if V is a constant value, I is a zero. Why? Because here if you observe the current equation, I is equals to C into dV by dt. When V is a constant, derivation of a constant value will get zero value. So then current I will become zero. That is nothing but capacitor act as open circuit in DC. That is nothing but where constant voltage is there, there will not be any current flow in the circuit. So this is the basic current and voltage across the capacitor. Now we will discuss about when two capacitances are connected in series, how can we calculate the equivalent capacitance. So to analyze that one, here I have taken two capacitances C1 and C2 connected together. So those two are excited by some voltage source V. So because of this voltage source, I am getting here one current I. So here I have assumed the voltage across the capacitor C1 is equals to V1, and the voltage across the capacitor C2 is equals to V2. So here if you observe, because of this voltage source, we are getting the current I. So the current I which is flowing through the both the capacitances C1 and C2. So already we know that whenever same current is flowing in the two elements, then we can conclude that both elements are connected in series. Okay. Now if you apply the KVL in this particular loop, now what is the KVL? Already we were in our previous lectures, we are already discussed about the KVL, Kirchhoff voltage law. So just remind the Kirchhoff voltage law definition. I'll give you 30 seconds of time. Just remind yourself what is a Kirchhoff's voltage law. Yes, the Kirchhoff voltage law states that algebraic sum of the voltages around the loop is equals to zero. So by the definition of Kirchhoff's voltage law, V is equals to V1 plus V2. Now, if we differentiate the equation, that is V is equals to V1 by V2 with respect to the time, that is dV by dt is equals to dV1 by dt plus dV2 by dt. But already we know that what is the current in the capacitor I is equals to C into dV by dt. From this equation, what is the dV by dt? dV by dt is equals to I by C. Now by utilizing the equation 3, if I remodify the dV by dt is equals to dV1 by dt plus dV2 by dt, I can get that I by C equivalent. Why? Because total current, when we have taken the total current, we need to consider the total capacitance. So I by C equivalent is equals to I by C1 plus I by C2. So now from I by C equivalent is equals to, from these two terms, if I take I as a common, I'll get 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. So from this equation, from left hand side and right hand side, I are common. If I cancel it, I and I, so I'll get 1 by C equivalent equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. So that is nothing but when two capacitances are connected in series, the equivalent capacitance can be calculated as 1 by C equivalent is equals to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. This is how we can calculate the equivalent resistance when both the capacitances are connected in series. Now we will discuss about when two capacitances are connected in parallel, how can we calculate the equivalent resistance. To analyze the equivalent capacitance when two capacitances are connected in parallel, here I have taken two capacitances C1 and C2 connected together. Again, it is excited by some voltage source. So because of this voltage source, I am getting one current I. Again, at this particular node, these two currents, this current resultant current I is dividing into two parts. The two parts of current, I am assuming it as a I1 and I2. So by the definition of current division, when the current has been division, that is nothing but dividing into two parts, we can conclude that, we can say that those two elements are connected in parallel. Now by the KCL, that is nothing but Kirchhoff current law, we can write that at a particular node the entering current has to be equals to the leaving current. That is nothing but I is equals to I1 plus I2. Here I is the entering current and I1 and I2 are the leaving currents. So by the definition of current in the capacitor, we know that I equal to C dV by dt. So here the total current I is equals to C equivalent into dV by dt. That is equals to I1 is nothing but C1 is the capacitance into dV by dt plus C2 is the another capacitance, that is C2 into dV by dt. Now from this equation, in the right hand side, I'll take dV by dt as common, and dV by dt, when we'll take dV by dt common, in the bracket we'll get C1 plus C2. Now we observe the left hand side and right hand side, dV by dt get cancelled, I will get the C equivalent equal to C1 plus C2. That is nothing but when two capacitances are connected in parallel, we can add those values directly. That is nothing but C equivalent is equals to C1 plus C2. So if we sum up together, when two capacitances are connected in series and parallel, here we can say that when two capacitors are connected in series, the equivalent value of capacitance is 1 by C equivalent is equals to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. While coming to two capacitors when they are connected in parallel, the equivalent capacitance C equivalent is equals to C1 plus C2. So this is how we can calculate when two capacitors are connected in series and parallel correspondingly. Okay, so in our today's lecture, we will discuss about what is the capacitance, what is the capacitance units, and how it can be indicated, and how the voltage across the capacitor and current across the capacitor, and how we can calculate the equivalent of capacitance when they are connected in series, and how we can calculate when two capacitances are connected in parallel. Okay, right? Thank you.